everyone. It is a week 10 update. And sorry, I haven't really had the time to do any videos really the past week. Been pretty busy. But not only that, it doesn't mean I've been flaking out or anything on my diet. In fact, I had some days where I did some extra workouts and that kind of thing. I haven't really done much Zumba the past week, I would say. I've been doing more of like that drop it in 30. Chris Freitag, I believe it was, is a prevention video. That's something that I've been doing, and it's pretty good. I like that video. And then I kind of got back into the Denise Austin Get Fit in a Flash, I believe it is, or no, Daily Dozen. So anyways, and been doing some of the T-Zone, at least 10 minutes every time I work out. The only day I missed so far has been yesterday, and maybe one of the weekend days. It was Saturday. I missed Saturday. Our son had a camp out, and we had four boys over, and I tell you what, that's quite the experience. Yeah, so like all my stuff, somehow they found their way into my office, which is kind of like a little cabin thing that I have, like, you know, big part of it is my office. The other part is the area where I have my workout equipment. I work out and that kind of thing. And them and their phones, you know, you come for a camp out, but you still can't live without your phones. And I mean, even though I had like outlets and stuff outside, you know, they still wanted to keep finding their way in my office. And I'm like, what the world? I find all my stuff messed up. You know, anyways, you guys don't want to hear about that, but I keep finding little things. And the other thing I've been doing is working on filing and paperwork, and it's not really one of my most favorite things to do, and I have to say it's kind of stressful for me. Probably is for a lot of people, but I know that there's people out there, boy, they love that kind of thing. And there's parts of it I enjoy, like I enjoy how much easier it makes work for me, finding things. I love that kind of stuff. I like the organization. I just don't like going through paperwork and that kind of thing. It's kind of boring and it kind of brings me down. Maybe you experience that when you, like, if you're somebody who's used to being out of the office and you're like working and you're going out and talking to people, doing presentations, that kind of stuff, it's really hard whenever you're not having all that activity and you're kind of like stuck. Some days that kind of bring me from here to down here, and then just, you know, a lot of different things that are involved with stuff. But anyways, to give you the update for week 10. I can't believe I'm saying that. Week 10. But I want to say hallelujah. And for the rest of you, that is week 10 or wherever you're at in your journey, congratulations. I mean, we're sticking with it. And that's a really hard part. I mean, we have the courage to see it through. We're committed. And it's only going to keep continuing to grow our confidence. And, you know, we're going to arrive to the goal pretty soon. I say pretty soon. It may take a while. For me, it's going to take a while because I've been losing weight slower than a lot of other folks out there. And a lot of it is because I understand my workload, my responsibility load, and how stressful that can be for me. So I know I have an underlying stress battle. And sometimes that can really affect your weight loss goals. And I think I'm really going through that right now. My stress level's pretty high at this point. And, you know, I feel most days really, really good. But it's just, it's really high. I got a lot of stuff going on. And so, I know it's keeping my adrenal glands just like pumping and that kind of thing. And so, that just makes it extra work, a little bit extra hard. And that's where, you know, I know to really lose weight, though, I need to be eating a lot lower calories, but the last couple weeks, with it being even higher than normal, and I had the cravings and all that, and that's just going to happen every month around that time. the way that it's tracking, and now that I understand that's what's going on there with the cravings and stuff like that, needing the extra calories. But when you have higher stress, I think it makes you tend to eat, but also to like kind of deal with it and kind of like protect your body. I think your body requires the extra calories. It's really weird. But it all works. I'll figure it all out. This is progress. It's a marathon, not a sprint. It's day by day. The good note is I'm the same. I didn't lose weight. I didn't gain weight. Inches, they're the same. So I'm happy to at least report that. It'd be really scary if I gained even more weight, because remember last week I think I gained like 1.4 pounds and I stayed at that weight this week. And I did lose inches though. I lost like 1.6 inches or something like that. But this week I didn't lose any inches or any weight. But I'm still doing good, even though I went through the cravings and all that sort of thing. So I'm doing good there. And so what am I going to do for today's workout? It's going to be the Get Fit Daily Dozen with Denise Austin. And then I'll also do like a cardio workout. So I'm going to go ahead and get to it. Hope y'all are doing well. Thank you for taking time out of your busy day. Join me on my journey. Listen to my update. Hope y'all are doing well. And keep it up. I mean, or if you're somebody who's thinking about doing a weight loss journey, don't think about it anymore. The first key is to go ahead and take action. And once you get started and you're rolling, you'll be able to continue with it. Don't think that you have to lose like 50 pounds in 4 months. Okay, let's be realistic, because a lot of times when you lose weight like that, you're going to gain it really fast back if you don't find good ways to maintain that, and you'll actually add another 10, 20 pounds more than what you lost, and you would have been better off just to maintain where you were, and it would have been healthier for you and your metabolism. So take it from somebody who's done it before. So I've lost that kind of weight. I lost like 60 pounds and it was like 60 pounds in probably 60 months. That's or 60 months, 60 pounds in like 6 months or so. And I mean, I think probably the first month I lost like 15 or 20, but I was on a really high restricted calorie diet. And that's why I know I don't want to do that this time. Plus I'm older and I don't think it's healthy to keep doing that kind of damage to my metabolism. So, cause I do believe that it does damage your metabolism. And I don't want to kind of do that to myself. And I don't want to put the extra stress of, oh my God, I went over 500 calories and I want to lose all this crazy weight. My goal is to get healthy and fit. Now I'm already in good health and I'm thankful for that, especially forcing my body to carry around all this extra weight. So I'm very thankful my body has put up with it, but I can't expect my body to continue to put up with that. I need to take care of it. And all in time, it'll all happen. So let's get to the workout. So I just did finish the 12-minute cardio kickbox blast burn. It's a 12-minute workout. And before that, I did the lower body sculpt and abs. So what's that? 24 minutes. it feels more like 40. But anyways, I said one thing I needed to start working on was drinking more water. I mean, I almost had that thought the last couple of days where I may just try to quit the cold, the Dr. Pepper cold turkey, and I'm not ready to do that yet. There for a minute I had a thought in my mind that I was ready to do that and ready to make that commitment, but I'm not yet. But one thing I'm doing is I got this mug, 64 ounces, you know, it talks about all the things about water on it, and my goal is to drink one of these a day. I'm sure there's a lot of other people that try to do that as well. Today is the first day, so I'm going to try to stay committed to that for a week, try it out, and see if I can accomplish it. You know, I'm sure this will be great and help me with energy and all that great thing, and probably help me burn a lot of that fat a little bit faster by having the water to help eliminate the toxins with all the working out and that kind of thing. So anyways, I want to thank you for taking the time out of your busy day and share my journey with me. I really do appreciate it. Your support is wonderful. I really do like reading your comments and your positive encouragement that you provide, and I try to do the same as much as I possibly can. And anyways, I'm going to get ready to do a reading, so if you want to stick around for the reading, please do so. Today the reading is going to be out of the Secret Door to Success. Love the stories out of there, and I believe the story is catching up with your good. So this will be a great story to go over, and I'm going to read that while I'm on the T-zone for you all, and I'll be right back and start the reading. If you haven't already subscribed, please do subscribe and leave a like if you enjoy the video. If you like the reading, please let me know, and I'll get right to it. Thanks. Okay, so today, the reading is from The Secret Door to Success. Whoops. Florence Scovel Shinn, an author that was basically called a prosperity doctor. People go to her for treatments. Basically to get rid of their bad thoughts and that kind of thing that would allow them to create success in their life and quit shutting doors to their own good. So she's a really great author. And today I'm going to do program one on the T-zone. What the world? Crazy thing. Are you gonna work? Or? Come on. Come on, man. Silly thing. Alright. Like I said, program one. Alright, so this is chapter, I believe, I don't know. Maybe chapter 12. Catch up with your good. And it shall come to pass that before they call, I will answer, and while they are yet speaking, I will hear. Isaiah 65:24. Catch up with your good. This is a new way of saying, before they call, I will answer. Your good precedes you. It gets there before you do. But how to catch up with your good? For you must have ears that hear and eyes that see, or it will escape you. Some people never catch up with their good in life. They will say, my life has always been one of hardship. No good luck ever comes to me. They are the people who have been asleep to their opportunities, or through laziness, haven't caught up with their good. A woman told a group of friends that she had not eaten for 3 days. They dashed out asking people to give her work, but she refused it. She explained that she never got up until 12 o'clock. She liked to lie in bed and read magazines. She just wanted people to support her while she read Vogue and Harper's Bazaar. We must be careful not to slip into lazy states of mind. Take the affirmation, I am wide awake, to my good, I never miss a trick. Most people are only half awake to their good. A student said to me, if I don't follow my hunches, I always get into a jam. I will tell the story of a woman, one of my students who followed her intuitive lead, which brought amazing results. She had been asked to visit friends in a nearby town. She had very little money. When she arrived at her destination, she found the house locked up. They had gone away. She was filled with despair, then commenced to pray. She said, infinite intelligence, give me a definite lead. Let me know just what to do. The name of a certain hotel flashed into her consciousness. It persisted. The name seemed to stand out in big letters. She had just enough money to get back to New York and the hotel. As she was about to enter, an old friend suddenly appeared, who greeted her warmly, and whom she hadn't seen for years. She explained that she was living at the hotel but was going away for several months, and added, why don't you live in my suite while I'm away? It won't cost you a cent. My friend accepted gratefully and looked with amazement on the working of the spiritual law. She had caught up with her good by following intuition. All going forward comes from despair. Science today is going back to Lamarck and his dent of wishing theory. He claims that birds do not fly because they have wings, but they have wings because they wanted to fly. Result of the push of the emotional wish. Think of the irresistible power of thought with a clear vision. Many people are in a fog most of the time, making wrong decisions and going the wrong way. During the Christmas rush, my maid said to a saleswoman at one of the big shops, I suppose this is your busiest day, she replied. Oh no. The day after Christmas is our busiest day when people bring most of the things back. Hundreds of people choosing the wrong gifts because they were not listening to their intuitive leads. No matter what you are doing, ask for guidance. It saves time and energy and often a lifetime of misery. All suffering comes from the violation of intuition. Unless intuition builds the house, they labor in vain who built it. Get the habit of hunching when you will always be on the magic path, and it shall come to pass that before they call, I will answer, and while they are yet speaking, I will hear. Working with spiritual law, we are bringing to pass that which already is. In the universal mind, it is there as an idea, but is crystallized on the external by a sincere desire. The idea of a bird was a perfect and divine mind. The fish caught the idea and wished themselves into birds. Are your desires bringing you wings? We should all be bringing some seemingly impossible thing to pass. One of my affirmations is, the unexpected happens. My seemingly impossible good now comes to pass. Do not magnify obstacles. Magnify the Lord. That means magnify God's power. The average person will dwell on all the obstacles and hindrances, which are there to prevent his good coming to pass. You combine with what you notice. So, if you give obstacles, oops. If you give obstacles and hindrances your undivided attention, they grow worse and worse. Give God your undivided attention. Keep saying silently, in the face of all obstacles, God's always ingenious. God's ways are always ingenious. His methods are sure. God's power is invisible, though invisible. Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not. In demonstrating our good, we must look away from adverse appearances. Judge not by appearances. Get some statement which will give you a feeling of assurance. The long arm of God reaches out over people and conditions, controlling the situation and protecting my interest. I was asked to speak the word for a man who was to have a business interview with my seemingly unscrupulous person. I used the statement, and rightness and justice came out of the situation at just the exact time I was speaking. We have all heard the quotation from Proverbs, "Hope deferred maketh the heart grow sick, but when the desire cometh, it is tree of life." In desiring sincerely without anxiety, we are catching up with the thing desired, and the desired becomes crystallized on the external. I will give to you the righteous desires of your heart. Selfish desires, desires which harm others, always return to harm the sender. The righteous desire might be called an echo from the infinite. It is already a perfect idea in divine mind. All inventors catch up with the idea of the articles they invent. I saw in my book, The Game of Life and How to Play It. Great book. The telephone was seeking Bell. Often, two people discover the same invention at the same time. They have tuned in with the same idea. The most important thing in life is to bring the divine plan to pass. Just as the picture of the oak is in the acorn, the divine design of your life is in your superconscious mind, and you must work out the perfect pattern in your affairs. You will then lead a magic life, for in the divine design, all conditions are permanently perfect. People defy the divine design when they are asleep to their good. People defy the divine design when they are asleep to their good. Perhaps the woman who liked to lie in bed most of the day and read magazines should be writing four magazines. But her habits of laziness dulled all desire to go forward. If your king pen is laziness, listen to this. The fishes who desired wings were alert and alive. They did not spend their days on the bed of the ocean reading Vogue and Harper's Bazaar. Awake thou that sleepeth and catch up with your good. Call on me, the Lord, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not. I now catch up with my good, for before I called, I was answered. That's a great read. So, yeah. Catch up with your good. Make a conscious decision every day to catch up with it. Perfect divine design. Pretty cool, huh? Especially how there's like the two inventors, but the bell was calling, or the phone was calling Bell. And he happened to be the one that wasn't sleeping in bed and reading magazines of Vogue or whatever she said, Harbor Breeze, all day like that lady. He took action And that's what each and every one of us need to do every single day to reach our goals and to keep moving forward in life, to have progress, because with progress is motivation. And also it creates an emotion for us to stay in motion to the path of success of which we want to obtain. And so the first key is always action. So if there's something out there that you've been procrastinating that you need to do, just take action, and it will deliver you a lot of freedom by taking action. The paperwork has been like major, like filing and all that problem has been like a major kind of like bondage for me, I guess you would say. I mean, I still have a mess over there of what I got to finish up and that kind of thing. But it made me feel better once I got it all like reorganized, a certain part of it that I needed to help me feel like I could be more effective. And that felt great. And so that feeling accomplishing some of that and continue to move forward is giving me great freedom and allowing my mind to focus on where it needs to be versus on the stupid paperwork consistently always getting in my way. So there's a lot of value in that. You want to lift all your bondage off of your shoulders. And sometimes just trying to make a decision, that also captures you and keeps you a slave. So if you're somebody who struggles making decisions, you might want to make a rule with yourself to start making a point to make decisions a little bit quicker and kind of develop a system of pros and cons, maybe a list, and then think about, will this deliver me pain or pleasure? And then decide your decision from that point forward. And like she says, though, you'll have greater success typically if you go with your hunch. So let's say that you're sitting there thinking, okay, so should I work out or should I not work out? If you have the hunch, I won't feel good, though, the next day if I don't work out, then maybe what is that telling you? You should work out. Or if you've had the hunch for a really long time that maybe it would help me in my journey if I started a journey and shared with other people who are looking for that, then maybe that's a hunch to go ahead and start your journey. You know, for me, I was thinking during the reading, I've had the thought a little bit about going ahead and how much better would I maybe be doing if I would just go ahead and make the decision to quit the Dr. Pepper. But I also know that you have to be committed to that decision. And so with myself, I'm just not there yet. It does not mean that it won't happen. Maybe it could happen as quick as next week. I just got to get my mindset to that place where I'm ready to make that choice to be committed. It's a big commitment. And I've got to level out my pain and pleasures on that because it is my vice. And, you know, I do limit two a day. So I was at one for a while. I was doing great by doing that. But anyways, thank you for your time. Hope you enjoyed the reading and I will see you next time. Take care. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Enjoy the rest of the amazing week that we have left.